Broadcaster Vince Marinello to life in prison for killing his estranged wife in 2006. WDSU News Channel 6 reporter Travers Mackle was in the Lafayette courtroom when Mary Elizabeth Marinello's family got the chance to address her convicted killer. Travers?
Well, Norman, some gripping statements made by family members in court today, but possibly the most telling statement came outside the courthouse, and what one family member was asked not to say to Vince Marinello before he was sentenced.
On the steps of the courthouse in Lafayette, family members of murder victim Mary Elizabeth Marinello come together. Inside the courtroom, they got a final chance to tell the killer, Vince Marinello, how they feel.
Hope that you'll find the rest of your days on earth as empty and as painful as you have made ours without Liz.
Claudia LeBrew is the victim's sister. She read a prepared statement in court, but was told by prosecutors to leave out the last paragraph she wrote. She didn't hesitate to tell us what it said.
Vinny said that in the family that there was a saying that he who laughs last laughs best. I just wanted him to know that it was Liz that's laughing last now.
Marinello did not speak inside the courtroom, even though he had the opportunity to do so. His hands and feet were shackled. He was dressed in an orange prison jumpsuit and was not wearing a toupee.
How is Vince doing? How's his condition? How's his well-being?
All things considered, I think pretty good for a man at his age facing the prospect of spending the rest of his life in prison.
Judge Con Reagan immediately remanded Marinello into the custody of the state. Prosecutors tell us he'll spend the rest of his life at Angola,
where he will live out the rest of his life in obscurity and anonymity.
Relatives say they just wish the 71-year-old was more remorseful. They say Vince Marinello has never apologized or admitted guilt.
In his mind, I don't think he to this day thinks that he actually committed the murder.
Jefferson Parish Judge Con Reagan made this statement to the court. What's amazing to me is from the time Vince Marinello learned of this crime, he never expressed any concern for any sorrow for the family of Liz Marinello. Marinello's lawyer asked Judge Reagan for a new trial today. That request was denied. He says they plan to appeal this conviction. Norman?
Travers, was Liz Marinello's daughter in the courtroom today?
She was not, but the daughter, as well as her father, her original father, did issue a statement that was read in court. In part, it called Vince Marinello a liar. Norman?
Now, Vince used to work with a number of us. How did he look to you today in court?
He looked very disheveled. He was dressed in an orange prison uniform. He was shackled. He was not wearing his toupee, and he looked unshaven and very disheveled.
All right, Travers, thanks for the report. Three of Mary Elizabeth Marinello's family members made impact statements today in court. You can hear two of those statements in their entirety by logging on to WDSU.com.